The numbers are staggering. More than 2,400 Americans killed on December 7th, 1941. The number of Japanese casualties, 64. Pamela Young has the story of how a remote Hawaiian community stepped up and answered the call for heroic action.
They took off from the carriers Akagi, Kaga, Soryu, and Hiryu. 360 Japanese planes. 29 would not return. Most were shot down at Pearl Harbor or out at sea, but one would actually land on the island of Niihau, setting off a bizarre sequence of events that would forever label the people involved traitors or heroes.
Well, the Japanese Zero was sort of the stealth fighter of the day, and the pilots were told, do not let the Americans get their hands on this thing. Destroy it, fly it into a building, fly it into a ship. But if you can get away, there's an isolated island up near Kauai called Niihau. And the pilots were told only Aborigines live there.
Who had no idea Pearl Harbor had been bombed because the island's only radio was broken.
So there was no contact with the outside world. So what did they do? They have a luau on Sunday night and invite the pilot,
who is friendly at first and convinces the three Japanese-speaking employees on the island to help him get back to the plane to retrieve weapons and flight papers. Over the next 6 days, now fully armed, the pilot and Hawaii-born Yoshio Harada shoot up the town, burn down buildings, and take islanders hostage in an attempt to find the flight papers, which had been taken and hidden by resident Howard Kaleohano.
No one is certain what the pilot did or said to make the three help him, but they did. It would be a decision that would seal their fate. The incident on Niihau would end with two people dead, two others tried for treason, and two heroes being awarded meritorious service awards for incredible bravery.
In his testimony to Navy investigators, Niihauan Ben Kanahele recounts the terror of the siege.
Harada said, they have enough ammo to kill off every man, woman, and child on the island.
Most of the Hawaiians scattered to the hills, but standing their ground are Ben Kanahele and wife Ella.
And they still say nowadays, don't shoot a Hawaiian more than once because you're just going to make him mad. And at some point, the pilot shot Kanahele.
Ella, she go after him and try grab the gun. I kept coming. I throw the guy against the stone wall, and Ella pick up one rock and brain him. I finish him off with my knife.
Realizing the pilot is dead, Harada shoots himself.
It's become the thing of legend because no one really knows why people did the things they did. But we do know for sure Ben Kanahele is the guy that stopped it.
The next day, Ben is put on a boat and taken to a Kauai hospital with three gunshot wounds. He is later awarded a Purple Heart and a citation by President Franklin Roosevelt. Howard Kaleohano receives the Medal of Freedom. The other Japanese conspirator, beekeeper Ishimatsu Shintani, is sent to an internment camp on the mainland. Harada's wife, Irene, is detained in a military prison for 2.5 years.
And one of those secret papers that cost the pilot and Harada their lives, they were turned over to Navy investigators who found a map of Oahu and a pilot manual of utterly no value to military intelligence.
Ella and Ben Kanahele had a son, also named Ben, and a grandson, Pu'uhonua, who goes by the name Bumpy.
And the things that I'm finding out about my history, right, is actually I realize who I am. Even more so because of what they did, right?
It makes me feel like I understand how my papa is and how everything is going on now, and like just the pride and like the power we get from it.
If you're supposed to protect your family and protect your village and your people, it's humbleness, it's bravery. You know, you walk towards it because if it's not you, then who else?
On another shore across the Pacific, in the town of Hashihama, stands a cenotaph in the Nishikaichi family burial ground. It is for a 22-year-old pilot named Shikinori, believed to have died on December 7, 1941. 14 years later, his parents would learn the truth, but they made no attempt to change the inscription. It still reads, "He achieved the greatest honor by dying in battle. His deed will live forever."